younger children. So last week we were doing division of fractions. Now we will be doing addition, subtraction, multiplication and division of fractions. We are moving on to the next chapter, and that is the decimals. Now these decimals we have seen before. For example, in rupees and paise, when we did in class 3, you wrote 3 rupees, 0.15 paise. 3 rupees, 0.15 paise. This point separates the rupees and paise. It can be written as 45.16. So, rupees 45.16. So, this decimal point separates the rupees and paise. Okay? So, what does this point, decimal point mean? Decimal point is a dot, a tikka that your mother wears. Not that, okay? Just a joke. Decimal point, a point. The dot, or the point between these two numbers, the two digits, is called the decimal point. Now, these decimal points we can have in rupees and paise, centimeters and millimeters, meters and centimeters. We can use it in so many other ways. So, it is important. Later on, when we do other types of sums, we may come across these decimal points. And these sums that we are doing is very, very easy. But before we move on to the sums, let's do the place value. Let me write a number, 3, 5, 6. Okay? So, previously, at the beginning of school, we learned writing the number name. How much is this? 356. The place value of 6 is ones. What is it? Ones. The place value of 5 is tens. The place value of 3 is hundreds. Or it can be written as 6, 5, 0, 50 or 3, 0, 0. When we expand, we can write the we can write 6 ones or 5 tens or 3 hundreds. 6 ones, 5 tens, 3 hundreds. Okay? Now we come to the decimal point. So this point separates the whole numbers. These are the whole numbers. Separates, and whatever comes after the decimal point are actually fractions. Okay? They are fractions. So let me tell you the place value. Now the place value of 6, for example, here we have ones, tens, hundred. But after the decimal point, we don't start with ones, we start with tens. Not with S, but with THS. Okay? With THS. For example, 2 tens. What is it? 2 tens. Let me write that, the place value first. 2 tens. THS. 3 hundredths. REDTHS. 3 hundredths. 2 tens. 6 thousandths. 6, so let me explain again. This one you know because we have done it. But let's move only up to the decimal point. So the place value of 2 is 2 tens. Place value of 3, 3 hundredths. 100 tens with THS, 1000 THS, tens, THS. So this number, when converted into a fraction, can be written as 2 tens, 2 upon 10. This can be written as 3 hundredths, okay? And this can be written as 6 thousandths. The place value of this 2 is 2 tens, which can be written as 2 upon 10, 2 tens. Place value of 3 is 3 hundredths, it can be written as a fraction as 3 hundredths. 6 thousandths, 6 thousandths. And this number can also be written in a decimal. Okay? So, this 6 can be written as, because there is no number, 0.006. Let me write that again. 0.006. I have written 6 because it says thousands. So I have to write 6 in the thousands place. There's no tens, 0, 0, and 6. It says 3 hundredths. So I have to write 3 in the hundredths place. There's no whole number, point, there's no tens, and we have to write 3 in the hundredths place. 2 tenths can be written in a fraction, 2 tenths, and in decimals we can write 0.2. I have to write it in the tenths place. Tenths place, 3 should be in the hundredths place, tenths, hundredths, 6 should be in the thousandths place. Tens, hundred, thousand. So that's how we separate the numbers. That these are the whole numbers, these are the decimals. So let us write the place value. Okay? By writing a place value chart. PVC. Place value chart. So let's write from the thousands. Thousands. Okay, let me write the number first. 4, 5, 6.124. Okay. Three thousand. Ones, tens, hundreds. Hundreds. So let me write one each. 5 tenths place value, ones. So the place value of 6 is in ones. 6 ones, 5 tenths, 400, 3 thousandths. After the decimal point, we have tenths, hundredths, THS, and thousandths. So, now let's not look at the numbers that are after the decimal point. So just say if you want to expand this 3000. When we expand, we write 3000, 3000 plus 400 plus 50 plus 6. Now when we expand after the decimal, we can write in decimals or in a fraction. So we have a point, this is 1 tenth, 1 tenth, 2 hundredths. 200, 4 upon 1000, 4 thousandths. Okay, so here we write 3456, then we write 1 tenth, 200, 4 thousand. This fraction can be written in decimals also. So it can be written as 0.1, this can be written as 0.2, should be in the hundredths, tenths, hundredths. This should be in the thousandths, 0.004. So we have written the numbers in fraction and in decimals. Now let's do about reading the numbers. Okay? Now when we read the numbers, what the numbers that comes before the decimals, we read it as we have been reading it before. For example, how do you read this? 456. How do you read this? 50. How do we read this? 1, 10, 100, 1,000, 7,015. So let's put a decimal point. Now you must remember that the numbers that are before the point are read as the same way we have learned. 456. Now what do you see? Point. Now you have to write what you see. What do you see? 1. What do you see? 2. What do you see? 3. So 1, 2, 3. Let's do that again. 456.123. 50. What do you see? Yes, you see 004. So 50.004. 7,015. What do you see? 142. 7,015.142. So that's how we read the numbers in decimals. Before the decimals, we read it as before 456. After decimals, whatever number you see, you write that 123004142. But not for this, not 5456. Okay? 456.123. Now let's read some fractions. This is 5/10. So how do you read this? 5/10. This is 1/100. How do you read? Children, today we learned about decimals and the decimal point. We learned about the definition. The dot or the point between the two digits is called the decimal point. We learned how to read the decimals. What, like after the decimal, how you should read in fraction and in decimals. So dear children, have a nice look at the video. Try and understand. So till the next class, see you. Bye.